It's icy out there. Very, very icy.
Ada lebih dari 300 ribu pulau dan 3.000 kilometer garis pantai di Swedia, hingga menjadikan negara Skandinavia ini sebagai rumah bagi beragam jenis kapal layar.
Motorboats use fuel that creates greenhouse gases. They can leak petrol and they can cause noise pollution. So I'm here to take a look at some electric boats that aim to overcome these problems, including one that doesn't cut through the waves, but glides above them. Right, yeah. I'm following you.
Yes, come.
Sirip di bagian bawah kapal sepanjang 8 meter ini dilengkapi sensor untuk merekam ratusan data.
You'll have to take the passenger seat first.
Okay.
And then we'll let you drive. We need to stabilize it, much like a fighter jet. Then we feel how we're oriented, where we are in the world. And then about 100 times per second, we adjust the foil while twisting it and changing the angle of attack to keep stable.
This is where it gets exciting. Let's go.
Cool.
Wow, I can feel the sensation of the boat lifting up. It does actually feel like we're flying. And without the hull in the water, it's using 80% less power than a boat would conventionally need.
Kekuatan mesin bertenaga baterai belum sebanding dengan bensin, tapi hambatannya lebih ringan karena kapal bisa melaju dalam kondisi mengapung di permukaan.
It feels beautiful.
Kapal ini bisa menghemat energi, kecepatannya mampu mencapai 20 knot dengan konsumsi daya setara dengan 5 knot. Dalam kondisi baterai terisi penuh, kapal bisa mengapung selama 2 jam dengan jarak tempuh sejauh 50 nautical miles.
And we can have a conversation like this. It's not like a slamming in the waves.
Which is yeah. Very sociable, and it also feels very smooth like an electric car.
You want to try it?
I'd love to.
Okay, let's do it.
Apparently this is easy, and when I raced a Tesla a little while ago and beat the race car driver, that was way easier than I was expecting, so let's do this. Seatbelts on, everybody!
Seatbelts on.
Okay, that feels faster than you went.
Okay, and now pull it down a little
okay,
bit.
Okay, pull it down, down a bit. Down. I'm heading for the big waves. Whoa! Whoa! That was amazing! I barely felt those.
Thank you for the warning. Hi, Kitty!
Performanya lebih unggul dibanding kapal listrik lainnya. Tapi begitu pula harganya, yang mencapai 300 ribu dolar. Apalagi jika dibandingkan kapal motor konvensional yang punya daya jelajah lebih jauh.
Of course, there's gonna be petrol-powered boats for quite some time, but I mean, once you try this kind of experience, it's quite easy to imagine everyone driving like this.
And when you're here looking at this beautiful water and the beautiful scenery, it feels good to know that you're not damaging the environment whilst you're out.
Produsen kapal Candela juga sedang membuat kapal listrik yang lebih besar sepanjang 12 meter.
This is our first electric hydrofoiling ferry. This one will be able to carry 30 passengers.
And it's exactly the same technology, just scaled up.
Yeah, exactly. It's the same concept.
Kapal listrik lainnya, X-Shore, menghadirkan koneksi jaringan yang lebih beragam. Dilengkapi GPS Garmin dan jam pintar untuk melacak posisi kapal.
My boat. Thank you. Thank you. It's a beauty. I believe you have something to give me before we get on board.
I have. So you will be able to start the boat with this one. Man overboard on, unlocked. And then if you fall in, then it stops. In 4 seconds, we will be up well above 30 knots. so everyone needs to hold on.
Is everyone ready?
Yes, give her everything you got, just full throttle.
Yep, I'm flooring it.
Harga dan kecepatan maksimalnya mirip dengan Candela, tapi X-Shore bisa melaju lebih lama dengan mode kecepatan rendah. Sensornya mampu merekam 150 data setiap detik. Semua data lalu dikirim ke pusat kendali untuk dianalisa. Inovasi kapal-kapal pintar bisa membantu pihak berwenang untuk memperbaiki kehidupan di laut, sama seperti mobil pintar yang dipakai untuk perbaikan tata kota.
So this is our R&D lab.
Some of this information, like water quality and water temperature, you can't do anything about it. So
no,
how much use is that data?
For the cities, it's lots of use because they can see if the temperatures sudden rises, where to go swim, where to avoid. If you have coral reef areas, I mean, this is something that our customers would want to monitor actually.